So some might think this is where the story ends, but there's much more to this story which I really want to tell you about. Let's play the intro. Okay, so first off, what I want to say is a big thank you for those of you that have recently subscribed to my channel. If you're new here though, above you'll find a link to the whole series showing where I started wearing my GoPro on my helmet and riding around Kingscote and Brownlow on Kangaroo Island. But in this episode, I'm wearing it on my chest, on what's called a chesty. I just adjusted it to make sure it was aiming straight. You will now notice that I have bright white legs and a neoprene cover over my right knee for an injury that occurred way back in 1992. Enough about that, we'll tell that story another day. For those of you that know where this video is going and what happens, bear with me, I just enjoyed capturing some footage of a few roads around Kingscote before heading down. No, not giving the game away yet, wait till we get there. Wait, no, I changed my mind, I'm heading down towards the hospital, change the speed up a bit. So you can see here that I pulled my leg out, it's just the injury on my knee that it has to be stretched out occasionally when I'm riding. So I just want to make it clear at this point that this ride has not been sped up in any way whatsoever. I've left it that way because with the GoPro on my chest, you get a much better view of what's going around me without all the head movement that I normally do. Hey, if you're another Super73ZG rider, take a moment to subscribe to my channel because I've got heaps more videos coming up like this, and more so with the GoPro on my chest, which is a lot more fun. You get to see a lot more of what's going on around me. I may be even adding a second GoPro, maybe the same model or a newer model, where I can see my face, what's going on behind me, and intermixing all of the footage together. More of that coming up in 2022. To the right of me is the Kingscote Hospital, but ahead of me is the Esplanade. Just up this ramp, this footpath slash bike path, I take a turn to the right, and I head on down towards the jetties. But to get to the jetties, I have to stay on this path, or do I? Some nice glide down, no pedaling, just around about here, all the way down. A bit of a dip in the road here, there's a penguin path to the left. And yep, through here, starting to see a few more people, noticing they're all together, I came to a halt.
We're good. Feels too good.
Here's something that I didn't notice until after I was looking at the footage, that car was actually parked on the walk and bike path. To my left is the old Pelican feeding platform and little building that Mr. John Aleph kept all of his stuff in. On my left coming up are all these seagulls, keeping an eye out for a bunch of fishermen doing what they do. Oh dear, no, don't do it! So there's no denying what I did here, so instead of deleting it, I've had a bit of fun. It's a Super 73, but not as we know it, Jimmy. Okay, so we're gonna head up here past the public park. If you've never been to Kangaroo Island before, this is an area of Kingscote you're gonna get to know fairly well, mostly because up there behind that pine tree is a public toilet. And if you're visiting here during school holidays, it's the ideal toilets for ages 0 and up. Originally I said I was going to record the whole 12-minute video, but I've changed my mind. I'm going to bring this episode to a stop in just a moment, just up here near the Aurora Apartments. To see more of this series, remember to punch the like button after every video, smash the subscribe button, and kick that notification bell right in the